That should do the trick. Now let's get that door open. That did it. Door should have power.
Now to see what lies beyond it.
Eclipse. They're here.
Avoid contact.
Lines look good.
Gaia, it's up there. Second floor.
Can you reach it?
So much for avoiding contact.
You won't survive this.
the last of them.
Alert. H-lock structural failure. Repeat.
Or not.
She's here!
That'll take you. On your target.
Room's clear. For a moment, anyway.
Then get moving. You have to find Gaia.
I'd have to ditch something.
I'm Margot Shen, and this is Hephaestus. As the name might tip you off, this is going to be the subordinate function that Gaia will use to make lots and lots of robots. Her personal forge. Except, it's not that simple. You probably noticed that only about a third of you are...
I think this is it. Elizabeth Sobek's office. But it's sealed off. There's got to be a way inside. More Eclipse.
Careful now.
Welcome to Apollo, the collective memory of the human species and the wellspring of knowledge for future generations. I am Samina Ebaji. Until recently, I was director of the International Collective Memory Institute in New Tehran. As a heritage professional, I devoted my...
glad no one...
Who's there?
No more sneaking. That's the last of them. Alone once more.
In what should have been a cave of wonders, look around. See if anything is left.
Welcome to Hades, Zero Dawn's extinction failsafe protocol, the ultimate killer app. Now, I know what you're thinking. The purpose of Gaia is to resurrect life. So why give her a subordinate function, only purpose of which is to wipe out life all over again?
What? It's just bum crazy, ain't it?
Well, no,
it isn't.
Reconstituting a biosphere? That's a tall order.
Looks like the only way onwards.
Welcome to Eleuthia, the crown and king of Gaia's subordinate functions. For it is by Eleuthia that the human race will continue to exist. I am Patrick Brochard-Klein, the Alpha in charge of this program. Now, let one thing be perfectly clear from the outset. Eleuthia is not a genetic engineering project. Our goal is to preserve the human genome, not alter it. A snapshot of human genetic diversity, literally, frozen in time. The genetic quintessence of our species, unmodified. Under my watch, our activities and initiatives will comply with the 2034 clone provisions and the 2048...
Cradle. Facilities. Elizabeth said a new generation of humans would be spawned inside such places.
She did.
Oh, Mother Mountain. It was one of them?
There's only one way to be sure.
The hatch wouldn't open. Something about a corrupted Alpha registry. I need to search Elizabeth's office. Something. Some.
But we benefit from antilopony morphologies, though caprid forms show superior load-bearing capability.
You're a quick study, Gaia.
Dr. Sobek, as I have conducted this comparative analysis,
you will undergo a brief period of unconsciousness during relocation to Prime in the following statement.
Elizabeth, please speak up.
When you're back up and running at the new site, we'll.
The Alpha Registry master file.
Intact?
Yeah. No signs of corruption.
Then what are you waiting for? Copy the file.
With this, I can restore the registry at the hatch inside Allmother. Open it. Go inside.
And grasp the secrets within.
Where I was born. Maybe. Maybe who gave birth to me.
Who? Are you really so naive? There will be no who waiting for you there, Aloy. Whatever birthed you into the world was a what, not a who.
You bastard.
Oh no, I had a legitimate birth. It's you, Aloy, who are the creation of a machine. But what kind of machine and why? Why were you created?
Eclipse.
You need to get out of there. What you found is too valuable. You're too valuable.
Suitable death in mind for you, child. My entire life, I've always known one thing with prophetic certainty. That I was destined for glory as a great champion of the sun. Even when Geron was murdered, even when Meridian fell, I never doubted my destiny. Until you came along. When I heard that you had survived, a doubt took root in my mind. As sure as the sun rises and falls each day, those I am bade to kill die. And yet I failed. How? Why? With each dig site you attacked, each loyal soldier you killed, this pestering doubt grew. I kept thinking of the moment my knife pierced your throat. One twist, a simple tug of the blade, and you would have bled out. In slaughter, I am a practiced hand. So why hesitate? Why fail my destined purpose?
I guess even a monster like you can have a glimmer of conscience. You didn't kill me right away. Turn your face to the sun, child. Dressing up murder as religious sacrifice so you could feel better about it?
No. I never doubted the righteousness of killing you. And yet, your words touch close to the truth. In my heart, I deemed the order to kill you unworthy of me. You were just a savage girl. So I thought at the time. Even still, I aimed to kill you, and yet did not. This failing troubled my thoughts, haunted every step. It was only when I captured you, down in that place, that I finally glimpsed the sun's design etched at length across the course of events. You were meant to survive that day on the mountain. Meant to interfere at dig sites and kill my men. Conversely, I was meant to capture you. Here. So that you might die as a sacrificial offering to the sun. Everything as it was meant to be. Predestined and preordained.
Some destiny. You're following orders, not some grand cosmic design. You're a puppet, with Hades yanking the strings, a pawn pushed around by larger forces. It'd be laughable if there weren't so much killing involved. Hades is an ancient machine, not the buried shadow of Karja myth. It doesn't care about Meridian. It wants to kill everything and everyone. And you are its dutiful slave.
I serve not the buried shadow, but the sun in shadow. All halves of nature joined to one cause. Shadow to sun, dark to light.
Do you really not hear how ridiculous that sounds? You've gone from serving an insane homicidal sun king to an insane homicidal machine. You're moving down in the world, not up.
I'll remember those words as I watch your corpse burn. Whatever's left of it. You fail to grasp the point. As surely as you've been conquered, so has all doubt. And with certainty of belief comes unstoppable force.
Then open this cage and put your faith to the test. See if things work out like you expect.
The circle has closed. Every element is in its proper place, exactly where it belongs. The errant beast, now caged, will serve her true purpose. A sacrificial animal. Oh, speaking of sacrifice, I forgot to tell you. After you crashed the Eclipse Network, I sent messengers into the East to rally the forces there and mount an invasion of the sacred land. I ordered every Nora killed. I was hoping to catch you there, but alas, it all seems to have been unnecessary.
Why butcher dozens of innocents for no gain? It's a waste of effort.
You're right. I won't even be there to enjoy it. In any case, I couldn't recall the order even if I wished to. Thanks to your destruction of the network, communication over distances is impossible. You not only doomed yourself, but an entire tribe. Do we not see the scorching judgment of the sun in these events? Your focus, such a powerful device, isn't it? And yet, so fragile. So you see, this time, I did not hesitate. The knife has already been twisted.
Faithful, rejoice! Our years in shadow are over. A new dawn trembles on the horizon. A new day, soon to break. And when it does, the false Sun King will be dead, and Holy Meridian ours once more. In this, I have become an instrument of prophecy. All halves of nature join to one cause. Shadow to sun, light to dark, night to day. Behold! Hold your seats! Can you not see the proof of the sun's blessing before your eyes? How else could shadows such as these prowl in broad light of day? Were they not approved by the sun and joined to our cause? Many years ago, to consecrate this great ring, the Radiant Turan ordered many faithless crushed beneath the hooves of the Behemoth. Mighty is the Behemoth in the eye of the sun, but it is mightier still, infused with the power of shadow. Let this one, who schemed and slithered, be the first to die! Let her be the first of thousands! Kill her! Kill her!
leave it to them. Come get me yourself!
So you're here. Really here. You risked your life.
Of course I did. If you'd been killed, the Nora Sacred Mountain would never have given up its secrets.
Too bad you wasted your time, then. Helis destroyed my focus. And the Alpha Registry with it.
Not at all. The whole time I've been monitoring your focus, I've duplicated every data file you scanned. Installing that data to a new focus was trivially easy. Happy birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man.
You're really good at making it impossible to like you, Silence. But I guess I need this.
It's time to see where you were born. Maybe you'll even learn why.
Yeah. Meet the machine that birthed me into this world. Isn't that how you put it?
I'll be off.
Wait.
Yes?
Since when can you override machines?
Ever since you discovered the technique. I had to destroy a corruptor to obtain the necessary parts, of course. But your example showed me how to do that as well. Yet another benefit of monitoring your activities through the focus. Truth be told, the underlying logic of the technique isn't so different from rites practiced by Banuk shamans. Though, of course, far more advanced.
Great. You're welcome, I guess. How did you track my location when I wasn't wearing a focus?
Really, Aloy? It doesn't take a genius to surmise that Helis would throw you into the sun ring at high noon. I wore out 2 striders getting here in time, but I did. Now be on your way.
Helis recognized you back in the sun ring. You told me that you'd assisted the Eclipse. Not that you knew the man who killed my... who almost killed me.
So now you know. The man is a serious threat. So let's do all we can to make sure that he and Hades don't succeed.
Right. I'll be on my way. To make matters worse, Helis ordered an Eclipse detachment to attack the Nora Sacred Land. The tribe's already weak. They won't stand a chance. You should come with me.
Well, absolutely not. I have preparations to make elsewhere.
What kind of... Why do I bother asking? You're not gonna tell me.
When the time is right, I'll be in touch. I'll contact you later. In the meantime, should you need to return to Shadow Karja territory, I brought armor to conceal your identity.
You think of everything, don't you?
One of us has to. Aloy, when you were recovering the Alpha Registry down in the Zero Dawn bunker, I was needlessly cruel. For your sake, I hope there is someone waiting there for you inside the mountain. Not a what, but a who. Yeah!